Okay, Adunya Sijnul Mumin. As in any prison, the independency is restricted. The people, they are not independent in prison. They have to follow those rules and regulations. Even some lawful things in general life, they are not allowed over there. So they have a specific area where they have to move. They have specific times to meet their relatives. All the time they cannot go everywhere. They have specific time for their independent activities. So, mean there are rules and regulations. As for a kind of field, the school is a kind of prison for some students. As here, we have to follow rules and regulations, uniform, timing, this and this. You cannot make party inside classrooms. So, mean you have to follow such kind of rules and regulations. For mu'min, this world, why is it prison? Because when we declare Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, then there are some rules and regulations we have to follow them. If we are not following, then it means we are not abiding by our oaths. And it should be done by both ways, by our tongue and by our hearts. So we have to do the things with sincerity. Now in this world, as we see, there are many things which attract us. But according to Islamic laws, we are not allowed to do those things. And there are many things which we don't like. But we have to do this. As 5-time prayer, in start it becomes very difficult for us. Especially in Pakistan or some other cold areas, 5-time you have to make wudu, get up, do this. But we have to do this. Similarly, every person, they want to enjoy the life, different kind of function, this and this. But Islam says that this kind of function has these limits. You cannot cross these limits. As now I am telling you about the scarf. So, as Muslim, we have this rule for modesty that we should not move outside our houses in the society like other people. Why? We are Muslim. And not only Muslim. Here you feel, see the word is mu'min. There is a difference between mu'min and Muslim. Muslim is the one who just declared shahada. Islam means submission. Muslim, the one who submitted. But mu'min, who is having this faith in his heart, as we say, اِقْرَارٌ بِاللِّسَانِ وَتَصْدِقٌ بِالْقَلْبِ, we have declared by tongue and we testify it by our hearts. How by our hearts? It means that we are doing this with passion, with sincerity, with devotion, with commitment. Then it will become easy for us. Now mu'min, for him this is sijn, this is prison. If we see the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he led his life apparently very miserable. Even when he was wealthy, when he became the king of Arabia after conquering of Makkah, still his life was not as other people mean luxurious life. No. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al faqru fakhri wal faqru minni," that faqr is my proud or pride, and I am from faqr. Faqr mean poverty, and especially faqr mean if in the morning I am having something to eat but for the evening I don't have. This is called faqr. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah asked Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you want, I will make Uhud, a mine of gold, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O Allah, I don't want this. I want to become your thankful, grateful person. If in the morning I am having something to eat and in the evening nothing, no problem for me, but I want to become grateful person to you. Hazrat Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha aur Hazrat Ans radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, they narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mostly